Hi, my name is Nina Mathiesen, and I am Developer Relations Manager here in Signicat. In the following videos, I'm going to show you how to get started with Signicat's Express APIs. These videos will show you how to integrate to the different APIs in the Express offering. So how is this tutorial set up? You may first be asking what is actually available in terms of tools, documentation, community support. Where do I find it? How do I use it? This current video will help you understand what is on our different pages and how you can find answers to your questions, whatever they may be. Then we will explain the different APIs and how they are typically used so you know which ones are for you. And once you know which APIs you will be needing, there will be several videos available on how to integrate the authentication API or identity validation APIs, as well as signature API. We're here at signicat.com. If you haven't already done so, you need to first create a user and sign into the Express solution. You can do that here, and you can do it here. Let's just press this one. Now, in order to onboard yourself to Express, you have to press Get Started in Minutes, and then click Create Account. So to do this, you only have to enter some information about your company, and then you're off, then you're ready to start. So I'm going to assume you've already done this, and I'm going to skip to the next step. It's found here at Developers. So again, this page really shows some of the differences between the two solutions. It also gives easy access to developer sites for each solution, here and here. So these are, as I mentioned, two separate offerings, but since we have open documentation for both of them, people sometimes start integrating to the wrong solution. And if you follow this tutorial, you will stay firmly within the bounds of the Express environment. But if you're ever in doubt, I'll explain how to find out which one you're in. So as you can see, you can also use this page to onboard yourself. But let's just go to the developer site. So this is the Express developer site, and you see at the very top, it says Signicat Express, and all Signicat Express pages end with .io. What we're really going to be explaining now is these tabs here, documentation, APIs, SDKs, status, community, and sign into dashboard. So let's just start with this one, documentation. So this page, it gives detailed documentation of all the APIs and all the products that are found in Express. And you can find them by just scrolling down here. You see general information, authentication, API, signature, API, and so on. Each API has a quick start guide, and you'll find information on how to authenticate yourself to the API and post-mine instructions and answers to common questions. So let's move on to the APIs tab and just use authentication as an example. So this page, it shows you specifications for APIs, and it gives in-depth information on endpoints for the different APIs that are included in the Express offering. So again, let's take authentication as an example, and you can see how to create authentication session. Let's just go here and click create session. Here you'll see detailed JSON properties that you have to include in your request. And it also includes every limitation on character field and what fields are required. A simple example request is also shown here at the right. So this documentation also shows you how an example response from an API will look like. Let's just scroll down and see it. You can see the example JSON up here and a detailed schema on all the properties that the API response would return. So you can check that out in your own time. Let's move on to SDKs. These SDKs, they make it really quick and easy for you to integrate to our APIs using different programming languages. We provide SDKs for .NET, Node, Python, and Java. All our SDKs are also openly available on our GitHub page. Then we can move on to status. You may also be interested in the status of our systems, which you can see here. You can also subscribe here to updates for any scheduled maintenance or in order to view the past incidents that may have occurred. So we deliver real-time updates on all the EID methods that are currently supported on our platform. And this is obviously also available for you even if you don't, you aren't a paying user of Signicat products. So you can just subscribe here, and at any time if you're wondering what's up with Swedish Bank ID or Danish Mit ID, you can just simply check the page and see if anything is indeed up. If after this video series you have any questions and you can't find them in the developer page, I will encourage you to have a look in the community. If you can't find the answer you're looking for in the community, you can post it yourself. So questions that are posted here do get answered pretty quickly. Let's just go back here. Finally, we have sign into dashboard, which shows both test environment and when you're ready, the production environment. So let me just explain the difference between the test and production environment. You have to have onboarded yourself if you want to enter either of them. And the reason why we offer a test environment is because identity providers, they require a test environment. So in the test environment, there are test users, there is test data, there is no real world data, and there are also no costs involved. You can onboard yourself, you can play around in the test environment, and there will be no costs. But when you're ready to move on to the production environment, there is a cost structure, and you must be onboarded with a real company, and you need to use real people to test with. This is it for the introduction. In the next video, we will give you an overview of the different APIs with some use cases so you can figure out which ones are for you. And if you have any questions or comments, please post them below or in the community page. And thanks for watching.